Hello everybody and welcome to the Creatrix YouTube channel. I welcome you all in a fresh session of analog electronics. And my dear friends, when I say we are going to learn analog electronics from the very basic, I mean it. We will be learning from the very, very basic level to the very advanced level along with a lots and lots of questions. So before we do that, let me first introduce myself for my friend who is meeting me for the first time. My dear friends, my name is Ankit Goyal. I got AIR1 twice in GATE in 2014 and 2018. I was awarded the President of India Gold Medal in the year 2013 when I graduated from IIT Indore. Till date, I have trained more than 1 lakh students in the online and the offline classes and presently working as a director at an academy for GATE department. But my dear friends, the reason behind this series is because of the huge demand of analog electronics. And the belief that whenever you ask for anything, we are there to deliver. Yes, my dear friends, we are here for you. We are here delivering for you. And when we say it, we'll support you to the very, very fullest level. And this series will help you crack GATE with the top rank. It will enable EC student to get 12 out of 12 and 5 out of 5 for electrical students. So my dear friends, if you want to learn with us live, then you can join an academy using the code ANKITASE to get an immediate 10% discount. And not only my dear friend 10% discount, it also brings you under my guidance so that I can help you do something that I have done. I can at least take you near to this goal. Okay, so if you also dream the same thing, then join me in this journey on an academy subscription using the code ANKITASE. Now, my dear friend, if you like the content that I deliver, you can watch more of my free videos on this URL, tinyurl.com/ankitase. Here you will find all my videos arranged subject-wise, chapter-wise, and you will find great content for free. And you are definitely going to love it. You are definitely going to enjoy. It not only includes conceptual videos, but it also includes problem-solving sessions. So just visit this once and you will fall in love with this URL. Don't forget it. It is a lifeline for you. And if you love the content that we are delivering on YouTube, we have created the first ever video book for you guys, where you will find all the videos along with all the notes that we provide arranged subject-wise, chapter-wise. So now, my dear friends, your dreams are no longer dreams. They are becoming a reality because you are getting a top quality course, well arranged, well structured, and that too for free. So what can be better than that? Nothing, my dear friends. So we have empowered the dreams of those who earlier used to think that only the person with a huge amount of money can crack GATE with a top rank. No, my dear friends, that is not the case. Even you can do it. But yes, just you need to believe in yourself and visit this link. But remember, this is a case sensitive link, so write this in uppercase. Other than that, if you join plus subscription, you get all the top educators like me teaching you live in daily lectures, along with providing you daily practice paper, weekly quiz, test series, previous year question, practice question, crash course, rank improvement batch, and most importantly, clearing your each and every doubt. So if you join plus subscription, it is an entire world inside it. So you don't have to look outside. Once you enter plus, every need of yours will be taken care of and we will make your journey as smooth as possible towards that destination of getting under 100, under 10 rank. Believe me, my friend, you leave that strategy part to us. You leave the content part to us. You just work hard and we will make sure that you obtain the top rank in GATE and ESE. And Iconic is a big brother of Plus. Yes, this is a little brother. So Iconic gives you everything that the Plus subscription gives, along with much more. The major part of Iconic is this personal coach, a person dedicated to you on a daily basis to get you the top rank, guiding you, getting your schedule designed, making your strategy. Everything that you need to get the top rank is being done by this personal coach. He'll also create a study planner for you, which you can follow blindly and reach your destination with utmost ease. They will be analyzing your test result and tell you where you are lacking, how you can improve. So that way, my dear friend, everybody else will get a standard analysis, but you will get an analysis just tailor-made for you. Along with it, we have included study material additionally, theory and question bank, and soon we'll be introducing interview guidance into this. So this will become a complete package for a student who wants to take that journey from being an average student to sitting into a PSU or a M.Tech seat. So for them, this journey will be just like driving a Lamborghini to work. So that sort of a experience, that sort of a royal experience we are going to give you. So let's move on to the lecture. And if you want to join an academy, just make sure you use the code ANKITESE to get my guidance as well as to get 10% over and above whatever an academy offers you. So now let's move on to the lecture, dear friends, and let's see what we have in store for you.
Hi guys, in the previous video we started with the topic of multivibrators. In multivibrator, I told you that they are of three categories: astable, monostable and bistable. In astable, what was the case? It did not have any stable state, so it keeps on oscillating between two states. In monostable, it had one stable state, so it went from stable to unstable by means of input signal and from unstable to stable on its own. In bistable, it had both the stable states, so it needed an input signal to switch the state from one state to the other. Then I introduced to you the concept of Schmitt trigger, which is also called as bistable multivibrator. And I told you that the Schmitt trigger is divided into two categories. One is called as the inverting Schmitt trigger, and the other is called as the non-inverting Schmitt trigger. Okay. Now what happens in inverting Schmitt trigger? The hysteresis curve was clockwise. In non-inverting, it was anti-clockwise. Here beta was R2 over R1 plus R2. Here beta was R2 by R1. UTP and LTP in both the cases was upper triggering point was beta V set and LTP was minus beta V set. I told how do we analyze a Schmitt trigger. Always we assume V0 as plus V set and minus V set and then check the value of input voltage at which output will switch from one state to the other. And I told when we apply a second source called as reference voltage, the hysteresis curve will shift to right or left, but the hysteresis width and height will remain same. So reference voltage can only provide left shift or right shift in the hysteresis curve. So in this video, what we'll do is, we know the Schmitt trigger, so we will understand the application of Schmitt trigger, how we will be constructing different circuits based on Schmitt trigger. That we'll see in this video. So the first application is the triangle wave generator. Now if you see the first part of this circuit is your non-inverting Schmitt trigger. Okay. What is the input voltage for this circuit? The input voltage of this circuit is actually the output voltage V0. Suppose this voltage is V. The second part of this circuit is your integrator. That means if you want to generate a triangle wave, then we must first generate a square wave. And if we integrate a square wave, what we will get is the triangular wave. So we will try to generate square wave using the non-inverting Schmitt trigger and then we will integrate this square wave in order to get the triangle wave. Now, what is the output of integrator? We derived in the chapter based on op-amp V0 was minus 1 by RC integral V dt. That was the value of the output voltage of integrator. Okay. So what I will do is, in order to analyze this circuit, let me say case 1. Suppose the output of non-inverting Schmitt trigger V is V set, then what is V naught? V naught is minus 1 by RC integral V set into dt. So it is minus V set by RC into t. Now what is the working of non-inverting Schmitt trigger? For non-inverting Schmitt trigger, what we say, if input voltage, if Vin becomes, if Vin becomes greater than beta V set, then V switches from minus V set to plus V set. That I derived for you in the last lecture. And I also told if Vin goes below minus V set, minus beta V set, V switches from V set to minus V set. Okay. Now see, here the input voltage is actually the output voltage V naught. So what I will say? I will say if V naught goes below minus beta V set, then V switches from V set to minus V set. So what I have done is, in this statement, I have just substituted Vin by V naught, because Vin is actually V naught. Now this is your V naught. So what I am saying, this V naught is linearly decreasing, and if it goes below minus beta V set, the V which we assume to be V set will switch from V set to minus V set. Okay. So what I will say, V naught is minus V set into T by RC. If it becomes minus beta V set, then V will switch from V set to minus V set. So what is the time T1? T1 is actually plus beta RC. Okay. That is your T1. So at this time, V will switch from V set to minus V set. Now I will take case number 2. Now V is your minus V set. If V is your minus V set, what is V naught? V naught is minus 1 by RC V dt. Or you can say dv naught by dt is minus v by rc. So you can write like this, dv naught is minus v by rc dt. Integrate both the sides. Okay. Integrate both the sides. What is initial value of v naught? In previous case, v naught became minus beta V set. So what is the initial value? Minus beta V set at time t equal to t1. Then V naught becomes V naught at time t. So V naught plus beta V set. V is actually equal to minus V set. Is minus minus plus V set by RC t minus t1. So V naught is actually minus beta V set plus V set by RC T minus T1. Now see this first statement. If V in which is actually V naught, goes above beta V set, V will switch from minus V set to V set. So I will say, if V naught goes above beta V set, V switches from minus V set to plus V set. So keep the value of V naught as beta V set. Suppose this happens at a time t equal to t2. So what is this t2 minus t1 then? It is 2 beta r. Okay. Where this r is actually r3. Okay. So you can write here as r3c. Here also as r3c. Okay. This much is clear. So now if I go by waveform, let me show you how this waveform will be plotted. See, I will plot two waveforms. One will be for the case of V and other will be the case of V naught. V naught actually have two levels defined, beta V set and here minus beta V set. So I'll indicate these two levels on the V naught waveform, beta V set and the second one minus beta V set. Okay, now initially what we assumed that V is equal to V sat, so V naught was linearly decreasing. So initially we assumed that V is actually equal to V sat, so V naught initially was 0, it started to linearly decrease. Now as soon as it touches minus beta V sat, V will switch from V set to minus V set. Now when V switches from V set to minus V set, the output starts to linearly increase. And when it touches beta V set, output goes from minus V set to V set. So it linearly increases, and when it touches beta V set, V will switch from minus V set to plus V set. Then it will again from case 1, it will start to linearly decrease. So now if you see the waveform at V naught, it is a triangular wave, but at V it is a square wave. This is the time t1, this is the time t2, and what is the difference in the times? It is 2 beta r3c. So this time is actually half of the time period, because full time period is the total one, this. So t by 2 is actually 2 beta r3c, which means time period is 4 beta r3c. Beta is how much for the non-inverting Schmitt trigger? r2 by r1. So what you can say, frequency of this triangular wave is 1 by t. So r1 by 4 r2 r3c. That will be the frequency of this triangular wave generated. Okay? So that is how you will analyze the circuit of triangle wave generator. No need to memorize this expression, because an identical circuit has a very less chance to be asked in gate. They can ask you a different type of circuit. Moving to the next application, the next one is called as astable multivibrator. Now what kind of Schmitt trigger it is? If you call VC is V in, then input is connected at inverting terminal, and hence it is inverting Schmitt trigger. Okay, so it is an example of inverting Schmitt trigger. The non-inverting terminal is grounded and we are connecting capacitor voltage as the input voltage at the inverting terminal. Okay. So now how do I analyze this circuit? First of all, understand that there is no current going at the negative terminal. So this R and C are in series. R and C are in series with V naught acting as source. So it is a series RC circuit in which your source is what? Source is V naught. Now I have always told you how to analyze the circuits based on Schmitt trigger. Assume the value of V naught as V set and minus V set. So let me assume case 1. V naught is V set and initially VC is 0. Okay. If this V naught is V set, then this RC circuit acts as a series circuit. See like this. This circuit is a series RC circuit with source as V naught, like this. Now if I want to find the value of VC infinity, what is the steady state value? Check this circuit. It is V naught, which is V set. Initially VC is 0. So how you will write the equation of VCT? VC infinity plus VC 0 minus infinity e to the power minus t by tau. So V set 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. That is the value of VC. Now, here there is zero current. So what is the positive terminal voltage? For positive terminal voltage, you can apply potential division. So you can always say it is V naught into R2 by R1 plus R2. Since 0 ampere current is going into the op amp, R1 and R2 are connected in series. And we can only apply potential division when connection is in series. Now V naught is V set. So Vp is V set R2 over R1 plus R2. Or you can call it as beta V set. Now see, the capacitor voltage, which is also the voltage of negative terminal, is increasing. It is increasing towards Vsat. But if Vp is greater than Vn, V0 will remain Vsat. But now Vn is increasing. It is increasing towards Vsat. And here beta is R2 by R1 plus R2. It is less than 1. So beta V set is less than V set. Now think like this. The voltage of positive terminal of op amp is beta V set, which is less than V set. But voltage of inverting terminal is increasing towards V set. At some time, it will cross beta V set. And when it crosses beta V set, that is when Vn becomes greater than Vp, V0 will switch from minus Vset. So V0 switches from Vset to minus Vset. So as capacitor charges towards Vset, at some point it overtakes the positive terminal voltage and it becomes more than positive terminal voltage. At that time, V0 will switch. Now suppose I want to find that time. For that, what I will do, I will keep V0 as beta V set, VC as beta V set, okay, and I will call that time as T1. So V set gets cancelled. So what is T1? T1 is tau ln 1 minus beta. Okay. That will be the time T1. Is it fine? I have just solved this equation and nothing more. Now see. Now we will go to case 2. Now V0 becomes minus V set. Since V naught switched from V set to minus V set, now V naught is minus V set. In that case, Vp was V naught R2 by R1 plus R2. It becomes minus beta V set. But now capacitor became charged up to beta V set. And VC infinity, if you see this circuit, VC infinity is always V naught, but now V naught is what? Minus V set. So you can write VC equation, it is VC infinity plus VC 0 minus VC infinity e to the power minus t by tau. So minus V set plus beta plus 1 V set e to the power minus t by tau. Now this VC is actually the voltage of the inverting terminal of op-amp. And what is the voltage of non-inverting terminal is minus beta V set. So now what I will say? If the negative terminal voltage is greater than positive terminal voltage, V naught will stay at minus V set. But if negative terminal voltage becomes less than positive terminal voltage, V naught will become V set. So I will say V naught switches from minus V set to plus V set. So let us see at what time does it occur. So I will keep Vn as minus beta V set. So it is minus V set plus beta plus 1 V set e to the power minus t by tau. Let me call it as t2. So V set gets cancelled from both the sides. If you take this 1 on the left hand side, 1 minus beta equal to 1 plus beta e to the power minus t2 by tau. From here, if you solve, t2 is tau ln 1 plus beta over 1 minus beta. That is the time at which output again switches from plus minus V set to plus V set. So as you can see in this circuit, output itself is switching from one state to the other, and hence it is called as a stable multivibrator. Now if I talk about the waveform of the circuit, so I'll draw two waveforms. One is for capacitor voltage and other is for output voltage. Okay, this is V naught. And then I will also draw VC. The x-axis is time. This is VC. Now see, initially we assumed V naught is V set. And I told you capacitor always tries to charge towards value of V naught. Capacitor tries to charge up to V set, but in between we have a level beta V set and minus beta V set. This level is V set and minus V set. Capacitor always tries to charge up to V naught or V set, but in between it finds a level beta V set. See what happens. Capacitor starts charging from zero. It tries to go till V set, but in between it finds beta V set. As soon as it finds beta V set, then what happens? The output V naught switches from VSAT 2 minus VSAT. Now capacitor will try to go till minus VSAT, but it cannot go till minus VSAT as soon as it reaches minus beta VSAT. As soon as it reaches minus beta VSAT, the output will again switch from minus VSAT to VSAT. As I told here, output goes from minus VSAT to VSAT as soon as capacitor voltage becomes minus beta VSAT. Then capacitor will charge from minus beta VSAT to beta VSAT. So capacitor waveform will be exponential, whereas output waveform will be square wave. So in this manner, we can generate a square wave. This will be the total time period T. We don't consider this interval. Why we don't consider? Because capacitor starts charging from zero. So this is called as the transient waveform. But when capacitor oscillates between beta VSAT and minus beta VSAT, this is called as steady state. So we have found out this interval. This one, that is actually T by 2. So what is time period T? T is 2RC ln 1 minus beta by, 1 plus beta by 1 minus beta. And once you have the time period, you can also find the frequency, which is 1 by time period. Okay. So just solve in one interval and then double that interval in order to find the period of the waveform. So what I have told, the time period is 2RC log 1 plus beta by 1 minus beta, where beta is how much? R2 over R1 plus R2. And frequency of oscillation is 1 by T. Okay. So you don't have to memorize this expression. Just remember, how did I analyze this circuit? So what I did? I actually analyzed it using transient analysis. I assumed initial value of V0 and then charged the capacitor so that V0 will change its state. But remember, in unstable multivibrator, V0 will act as a source for the series RC circuit. Okay. The third category is the monostable multivibrator. Now this monostable multivibrator is also called as mono short multivibrator or one short multivibrator. So what I have told you about monostable multivibrator, that it has one stable state, that is it will go from unstable to stable state by its own. Okay, but it will go from stable to unstable state only when you apply the input. Okay. So, what I have told about monostable, it goes from unstable to stable by its own, but it goes from stable to unstable by applying an input. Okay? See, what will happen actually? What will happen is, initially, suppose diode is on. If the diode is on, what is the voltage of negative terminal? It is 0.7 volt. Okay. And you push this switch. We push trigger. Then positive terminal voltage becomes 0. In that case, negative terminal voltage is greater than positive terminal voltage, and output will become minus VSAT. But remember one thing, this switch is such that we will push this switch and suddenly we will switch it off. Like the case of a button, if you see your remote, if you push the power button, you will remove the hand immediately. So it will come back to its original position. That is, trigger is only pushed momentarily. Trigger is only pushed momentarily, then it will again be turned off. Okay, but due to that momentary push, V naught becomes minus V set. Now we know the current here is 0 ampere. If the current here is 0 ampere, R1 and R2 are in series. So we can find out Vp. Vp can be found out by voltage division V0 into R2 by R1 plus R2. So minus V set R2 by R1 plus R2, or you can say minus beta V set. But since V0 becomes minus V set, due to negative voltage, diode turns off. V0 is minus V set, so diode turns off. Now see this circuit. It becomes a RC circuit, just like the case of R stable multivibrator. So RC circuit or series RC circuit is formed. What is the supply for that circuit? The supply for that circuit is V0. Just like R stable multivibrator, V0 will act as a source for RC circuit. So what will happen? Initially capacitor is discharged. How I am saying this? If we take it as an ideal diode, what is the voltage drop across the diode? The voltage drop across the diode is 0. That means initial capacitor voltage is 0. Here I have taken 0.7 just to show that the output will become minus Vsat. But if you take ideal diode, the capacitor voltage will be 0 because initially diode was on. So initially capacitor voltage is 0. What is steady state capacitor voltage? It is V0, which is minus Vsat. So how you will write VCT? VC infinity plus 0 minus infinity e to the power minus t by tau. So minus V set 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. This is actually the voltage of negative terminal. Now see, if positive terminal voltage is less than negative terminal voltage, V naught will remain at minus V set. But actually the capacitor voltage is decaying. The capacitor voltage is decaying towards minus V set. But positive terminal voltage is minus beta V set. So at some time it will cross it. Okay. Capacitor is charging to minus V set. So at some time it will cross minus beta V set. So if Vn crosses minus beta V set, then Vn becomes less than Vp. If Vn becomes less than Vp, V0 becomes V set. If V0 becomes V set, so let me check the time at which it occurs. Let me call that time as T1. So from here what I will get is T1 is tau log 1 over 1 minus beta. At this time V0 will become plus V set. If V0 becomes V set, then V0 is positive. If V0 is positive, then capacitors charges towards V set, because capacitor always tries to charge towards V naught. But as soon as capacitor voltage becomes positive, as soon as VC becomes greater than 0, diode becomes forward bias and VC stays at 0. As soon as this capacitor voltage will become positive, capacitor is charging towards V set. So So if capacitor starts charging towards Vsat from here, like this, it will cross zero. As soon as it crosses zero, diode becomes forward bias and Vc becomes zero. What about Vp? Vp was V0 into beta. So beta Vsat. Okay, because V0 becomes Vsat. Now the negative terminal voltage is zero, but positive terminal voltage is beta Vsat. So Vp is greater than Vn. So V0 will be Vsat. That means this is the stable state. The circuit will keep on staying in Vsat. It will not leave this state. And that means it is monostable multivibrator. The state of the output Vsat is stable. Whereas if you want to make it minus Vsat, you have to push the trigger. Let me show you this by means of waveform. Okay. Again, I will draw two waveforms, Vc and V0. So first we will see the waveform of V0 and then we will draw Vc. So initially I was saying that circuit is resting in the state of Vsat. Suppose. And diode was forward biased, so capacitor voltage was zero. Suppose at this time trigger is pushed. As soon as trigger is pushed, we saw output switched from Vsat to minus Vsat. And capacitor starts charging. Capacitor starts charging towards minus Vsat. Okay. Capacitor starts charging towards minus Vsat. But as soon as it reaches minus beta Vsat, the output switches from minus Vsat to plus Vsat. Okay. Then due to that, capacitor starts charging towards plus Vsat. But as soon as it crosses zero, capacitor starts charging towards Vsat. As soon as it passes zero, the diode becomes forward bias and the voltage stays at zero. So output will stay in Vsat. So that means when you push the trigger, output becomes minus Vsat for a certain time, let us say T. And then it will come back to Vsat and keep on staying in Vsat until you push the trigger again. So from minus Vsat to plus Vsat is by its own, but from Vsat to minus Vsat we have to push the trigger. So Vsat is your stable state in which it can stay as long as possible, and minus Vsat is unstable state in which it will stay only for short duration. So this T is called as pulse width, which we derived as RC ln 1 over 1 minus beta. So monostable multivibrator is used to generate a pulse of width RC ln 1 over 1 minus beta. So if I summarize what we have covered in this video, we have seen triangle wave generator, which is basically non-inverting Schmitt trigger plus an integrator. Then we saw what we saw, unstable multivibrator. Okay, in this we were generating a square wave using inverting Schmitt trigger. We derived that the time period was 2RC ln 1 plus beta by 1 minus beta, and beta was R2 over R1 plus R2, but it is better to analyze it as a transient circuit. Then we saw monostable multivibrator. Here it generated a pulse of width RC ln 1 over 1 minus beta, and the stable state was Vsat and minus Vsat was unstable. Okay, so that is all about application of the Schmitt trigger. Okay, so these are the oscillators that you can generate using op-amp, or you can also say positive feedback applications of op-amp. This much you need to understand, and if you keep it like circuit analysis, you won't have to memorize any formula. Okay, so this is all from this video. Thank you.
I hope all of you have enjoyed the lecture that we were providing, and all of you learned something very, very good. Now is the time to learn about the Unacademy subscription. So as I told the benefits of the Plus subscription at the very beginning, let's go through them very, very quickly. Live classes you get by the top educators, crash course, rank improvement badge, doubt clearing, weekly quiz, test series, previous year question, practice question, everything in one subscription called as Unacademy Plus. And iconic is one level higher. It provides you a personal coach who will mentor you on a daily basis, who will guide you on a daily basis, along with providing you study planner, test analysis, study material, and soon enough, interview guidance. So if you are looking to join an academy, let's see what are the pricing. So my dear friends, before we see the pricing, just see the link. This link will help you crack GATE and ESE with the top rank, because we have created the first ever video book for GATE and ESE for my YouTube family, and you will get the notes as well as the lectures here. Just make sure that you write this link in the uppercase and you will get to the first ever video book for GATE and ESE, and it is nothing but revolutionary. Now let's see the pricing of Plus subscription. So for 12 months the pricing is 3250, but if you apply the code Ankit ESE, it becomes 27225. For 18 months it will be 34650, and for 24 months 39600. Believe me my dear friend, this is the most affordable pricing, and the longer duration subscriptions are more cost effective as compared to shorter duration. Like here it will cost you 1650 per month. Okay, this will be 2000 per month approx. This will be around 2250 per month. Then if you go for iconic for 12 months, it is 5250 with code Ankit ESE, it becomes 45225, and 2 year subscription becomes 66600. So the choice is your, but take a longer duration subscription for more cost effective solution, and to give GATE and ESE at least 2 times, so that if you once crack GATE, in the next attempt you can even get ESE. And other than that, my friends, you can download the Unacademy Learning app right now, because there we provide live classes for free, test series, and live quizzes for free. And once you download it, make sure that you follow this profile. This is my profile, so that whenever I come live, you will get the notification. And this is the Telegram channel for our team. Here you will find all the lecture links, all the lecture files, and all the links for the special classes. Other than that, my friend, my personal Telegram channel also you can join, t.me/gateair1. Here you can get in touch with me and we can take this journey together. Okay. Other than that, we have other YouTube channels like Mechanical, Civil and Telugu, JE channel, Computer Science, GATE Question and Electrical Junction, Paathshala and GS Terminal. Electrical Junction contains short videos of great concepts. Paathshala provides you animated content. JE preparation can be done through these two channels, Unacademy SSC JE and GS Terminal. And you can refer the other channels to the other friends in respective branches so that they can also be benefited. At last, I would like to say, please share, like and subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to this channel, and not only subscribe, press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever a new video comes. And share this videos among all your college group, among all your friends, so that we can create the first ever revolution of free education in field of GATE and ESE. Thank you to everybody for dedicating time to watching this video. please move on to the next one as well and take the benefit of all the free content that we are providing. And in case you have completed the series, do make sure you watch the other subjects available on this channel. Thank you.